ahimè, un grande fondista, quindi lo vedremo.
Now, the second of three Nordic combined events was the highlight of action at the Winter Universiade on Monday. On Friday, there was success for Poland in the individual Gundersen 10-kilometer cross-country race. Adam Cieslar took the honors. Germany's Johannes Vassel took silver, and Aguri Shimizu of Japan grabbing bronze. All three again in contention for the Nordic combined mass start. 42 hopefuls from 14 countries in contention. Russians dominated the field, 7 entrants, 5 Germans, 4 Slovenes and Japanese. In addition, 3 each from Austria, Estonia, Norway, Poland and Ukraine. The event started with a cross-country skiing competition in Lago di Dazzero, around 75 kilometres in Trento, 4 loops of 2.5 kilometres. In the early stages, Espen Andersen of Norway stormed to the front. Shimizu was just behind. Itu Viherisorinki and Shota Horigomi of Japan completed the early top 4. Nordic combined, familiar to followers of the Winter Universiade since the very first edition in Chamonix, France, back in 1960. This is the only event seen in Trentino not open to women. The start of the first kilometre, Andersen was still ahead, Horigomi and Samir Mastia just behind. Before 2 kilometres were up, Finland's Vihesorinki had raced to the front. He was followed by Cieslar, Andersen and Vyacheslav Barkov, who was getting stronger by the kilometre. Near perfect conditions in northern Italy, temperatures around zero, under bright sunny skies. Now, this is only the third time the mass start has been part of the Universiade. Both previous winners came from Japan. Aguri Shimizu taking gold in 2011, Koichiro Sato 2 years earlier in Harbin, Takahito Nagai and silver for Japan in 2009. Poland and Switzerland, the only other countries with medals. After 3.8 kilometres, the competition was getting intense. Mads Christopher Vala of Norway showing what a talented skier he is. Now to the halfway mark, 5 kilometres gone, and the top 4, Vala, Vihesorinki, Cieslar and Barkov. Two others were making a play for the leading spot. Matti Taponi Herola of Finland's 5th, Samir Mastiev of Russia completing the top 6. Vala studies at the Lillehammer University College at the halfway point. Must have been dreaming of glory. Coach Evan Andreas Rudd, no doubt, delighted with the early display from the 19-year-old. Skiers readying themselves to dig deep the final part of the race at Lago di Tesero. At the 7.5 kilometre mark, Vala still ahead, Barkov was second. Cieslar clearly determined to get a second medal here in Italy and was still in the top 3. Pawel Slowiok of Poland, 4th at this stage. Now this was the key part of the race. Barkov showing he had plenty left in the tank, more than 8 kilometres gone. He waited for the right moment before edging past Slowiok. Barkov just got stronger after that, leaving the rest in his wake. A superb ski this from the student at Moscow State Humanitarian University. Into the last 1.5 kilometres now, Barkov showing superb technique and power. Slowiok hanging on in second place but was tiring. His countryman Cieslar third at this stage. 21-year-old Barkov superb here, winning in 25 minutes 20.6 seconds. He gets 120 points for that. Slowiok was 3 seconds back, 0.8 points behind. Vala 7.6 seconds behind the winner, so went into the ski jumping contest with a 2-point deficit. Emil Wilhelmsen of Norway finished strongly. He was 4th, 9 seconds behind the winner. That means he's 2.3 points behind Barkov. Shimizu was 5th, with Cieslar settling for 6th place. The competitors then heading to the ski jumping venue at Predazzo, which has an altitude of around 1,000 metres. 2 rounds of ski jumping will await to decide the medals. So an exhausting day in Italy, Russia, Poland and Norway, the top three before the ski jumping. Barkov, Slowiok and Vala, the men to beat. So after the mass start, the Nordic combined competitors headed to Predazzo for two rounds of ski jumping. 21-year-old Vyacheslav Barkov had a slender lead, needed to show he was as adept on the normal hill as he was in the cross-country skiing event. There was little in it, and a dozen entrants had a realistic hope of winning. Aguri Shimizu was only fifth after the cross-country section, but the defending champions jumping top-notch, boasting jumps of 73.5 metres in the first round, 77.3 in the second. Those were the fifth and second best respectively, 150.8 points in the ski jump, 268.5 the total. Shimizu taking top place on the podium and continuing a magnificent run for Japanese competitors in this event. The country has won all three golds since the mass start format was introduced in 2009. Now Adam Cieslar has had a quite magnificent Universiade. After winning gold in the individual Gundersen, the Pole jumped superbly from silver in the last start. He jumped consistently 75.5 and 74.1 metres for a points total of 149.6, 267.1 points. His total of just 1.4 points behind the Japanese winner. Cieslar, remember, only sixth best in the cross country, but like Shimizu, showing that consistency is what matters in this sport. His jumps third and fourth best over the two rounds. Cieslar turns 21 on Wednesday, can certainly celebrate in style, and a fine day for Poland. Pawel Slowiok taking a creditable bronze medal, second ahead of the ski jumping sessions. His strength is in the cross country, and the Pole did just enough to take home a bronze medal, 262.2 points overall. Not such a memorable session for cross country winner Barkov, though. He had a disastrous session, and the Russians slipped all the way down to 12th place. 120 points going into the two jumps. He had made 120.6 to his total. He ended up at 240.6 out of the top 10. Seven Russians started the race, but the nation leading the medals table without a medal here. So what of Mads Vala, the Norwegian, who was impressive in the cross-country event? Vala remember led the cross-country at the halfway stage. Like Barkov, he was let down by his ski jumps, 57.8 and 55 metres, only 23rd best in each round. That added 112.8 points, total 240.8. Only 14th for the teenager from Lillehammer University College. The Finns had an inconsistent day. Their best performer was Matti Herola. He rose from 7th in the cross country to 4th overall. Two respectable jumps, 72.4 and 69.2 metres, gave Herola 141.6 points. And was 4.6 points behind the medalist Slowiok. Well back, but ending in 4th, always a frustrating experience at a major international event. Forty-two hopefuls from 14 countries in contention. The outstanding performer on the 106-meter hill, Tobias Siemen, one of five Germans in contention. Siemen jumped 78.8 and 78.7 meters, the best performance on both the first and second rounds. Siemen was only 24th after the cross-country race, so had far too much ground to make up. The Fort Wangen University student finished 6th overall on 252 points. Seaman, the only German in the top 10, Sebastian Vella, ended in 18th position. So Shimizu does it again, retaining the gold medal that he won 2 years ago in Turkey. 268.5 points, a total worthy of gold. Poland take two more medals, thanks to Cieslar and Slowiok. Vi ci assicura il comune di Predazzo. Gioca a basta.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the flower ceremony for Nordic Combined Masters.
Nice moments here in Predazzo, and we hear us and see us again tomorrow. Also, eine wunderschöne Abend noch.